Hey everybody, this is Rishi, and in this video, I'm going to show you another classic case. Now, this case started from this chest x-ray, and if you zoom in on the retrocardiac region, you can see that there's an opacity right here overlying the left heart. Usually when there's something that's overlying the heart, it's in the left lower lobe. There's very little lung tissue that's anterior to the heart, although there is a little bit. Another reason why we can tell that this is in the left lower lobe is if you look at the descending aorta, it obscures the descending aorta, so therefore it must be in the left lower lobe. And even though I know where it is, I can't really see it on the lateral view. So at this point, my differential for this chest x-ray would be either a pneumonia or a lung cancer, and this patient wasn't having any symptoms of pneumonia, so a chest CT was done. When we look at this area on CT, it shows up as an area of consolidation and volume loss in the left lower lobe. And you can see that it abuts the aorta, so it's easy to understand why it would obscure the descending aorta on the chest radiograph. Now, when we look at the soft tissue windows, you could see that there is a vessel that arises from the left lateral aspect of the aorta and goes directly into this lesion. So this is something called a bronchopulmonary sequestration. And there's two types of sequestrations, intralobar and extralobar. Intralobar sequestrations are part of the normal lobe, so it's encompassed within the left lower lobe or right lower lobe usually. Whereas an extralobar sequestration is like its own little lobe, like it has its own separate pleura. And when we look at this case, you could see that this sequestration, this abnormal lung, does not have its own pleura. It's part of the rest of the left lower lobe, so this is an intrapulmonary sequestration. Now, this is a unique case because if you look further on the soft tissues, you could see that there is another vessel that arises from the anterior aspect of the aorta, and it goes to the right side behind the esophagus, and it goes into the right lower lobe. So in this case, there are bilateral intralobar bronchopulmonary sequestrations. So let's talk about bronchopulmonary sequestrations for a second. A bronchopulmonary sequestration is just an abnormal area of lung tissue that doesn't connect with the central tracheobronchial tree and is supplied by a systemic arterial vessel rather than the pulmonary artery. So what are the differences between intra and extralobar sequestration? So first of all, intralobar sequestrations are more common, occurring in about 75% of cases. They both have systemic arterial supply because that's part of the definition of what a sequestration is. But they differ in that intralobar sequestrations have pulmonary venous drainage, whereas extralobar sequestrations are usually drained by a systemic vein and rarely by a pulmonary vein. Intralobar sequestration shares its pleura with the adjacent lung, and because of the pores of cone and anomalous bronchi that can connect with the rest of the lung, these are more likely to present with infection compared to extralobar sequestrations. Extralobar sequestrations have their own pleura, and therefore infections are less common. Extralobar have more associated anomalies, which can include things like congenital diaphragmatic hernia, congenital heart disease, vertebral anomalies, and colonic duplication. Both of these types are frequently associated with CPAMs, and these are called hybrid lesions, so it's not uncommon to see a sequestration with internal cystic areas. The treatment of these, particularly if the patient is symptomatic, is surgery. And even asymptomatic patients, if the sequestration is large or multicystic, surgery is usually recommended. This patient never followed up, so I'm not sure what happened to them. Bronchopulmonary sequestrations are not rare lesions, but it is rare to have bilateral bronchopulmonary sequestration like this patient had. Many people believe that intralobar sequestrations are acquired lesions resulting from infection, and that may have been the case in this patient, but we don't know that for sure. All right, so this was a case of bilateral intralobar bronchopulmonary sequestration. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Thanks.